Welcome to the Felix Smart Studio. This is the second video in a three-part series explaining all about how to build a completely automated, scalable hydroponic system. In this video, we will be going over how to build a hydroponic system using the supplies that we collected in the previous video. If you do not know what supplies you need to build this system, go watch our previous video. It'll also be linked down in the description. To begin, I will set up the rack. This is going to be like our canvas for this hydroponic system. Taking out all the bits and pieces of this this tower here, it looks to be by far the most complicated part of this hydroponic system. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 7, 8. We're gonna put our first level here, 6, 7 next level, and that should give us even spacing so that the plants have enough room to grow and we can keep our water out of the way. Yeah, not quite. To make sure we are securing this to the best of our ability, we're just gonna use a mallet and knock it down. Good work, Rob. Now that our rack is constructed, we're gonna be securing some full spectrum grow lights to the rack using zip ties. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I am just lining up these lights first so that we can just go like right up and make sure we get the right spots as to not make a mistake. We actually made a mistake the first time around and only put up two lights aside. So now we're redoing it. So don't make the same mistake as us. So just as a general rule of thumb, we're gonna keep all our wiring, like our actual plug portions, off to this side. That's where we're gonna be plugging them into their power source, which is Kai, the Felix Smart controller. And now that we've got everything plugged in, all there's really left to do is... Next, I'll be making modifications to some of our supplies. We need to drill a circular hole into the bottom of each one of our trays to allow water to flow from one level to the next. We will also need to cut a block out of each one of the styrofoam pieces to allow a tube to enter the trays. Now that we have cut our alternating corner holes, we're gonna be cutting a middle section out of the opposite side as the hole on each of our styrofoam pieces, and this is gonna allow the drainage plug. All right, so now I'm gonna use an Ebb and Flows fitting kit to plug up the holes that I just drilled in each one of my trays. You wanna use an X-Acto knife to actually smooth out these edges, otherwise your system's gonna leak because the rubber isn't gonna seal properly. When you are plugging the hole in each of the bottom of your trays, you wanna make sure that this rubber piece is on the top of the hole. You can put it just like that, and then you'll screw this piece underneath the hole. So that'll end up plugging the hole and preventing any water from getting through. Okay, now I'm gonna begin the tubing process. So I'm gonna be using this tool to cut my tubing to the desired length so that we can make it all the way around this system. And always remember to leave your tubing on that little bit of the long side because you can always make it shorter down the road, but you cannot add that length back on. Now I'm gonna attach my longest tube in the reservoir to this submersible water pump and leave it in there for now. I'm also gonna make sure that this power cord is out to the side that I've designated and out of harm's way. You're going to wanna poke a hole in the tube of the top tray to prevent water backflow. Now that our tubing is all set out, we can start filling our reservoir with water. And while we wait, we can start filling our styrofoam sheets. So I also added this tray on the bottom of my reservoir to get my reservoir off the floor so that water doesn't condense onto my hardware. So when I'm actually taking my pods and putting them into my raft, I want to be very careful to make sure the roots here actually get all the way down where they're supposed to go. They love to get stuck on the sides, but if they're stuck on the sides, they can't soak up any water. Make sure that finds its home. In addition to this lettuce, actually, we have wasabi arugula growing. We have shiso growing. That'll be a total experiment for us. Mm-hmm.
By the way, if you don't know how to start seeds, we have a tutorial out just for you.
Now that I have all my pods into this raft, I can put it into my system and show you exactly how it's gonna go. Now you can actually see why I cut these pieces out, because boom, perfect fit like a puzzle. I just put my seed pods in there so that you can see exactly what it's gonna look like in the end. But before you put your pods in, you wanna make sure to cycle nutrients throughout your system for about 24 hours. Now, among the last steps here, I'm gonna add in my air pump. To do this, I'm going to fasten it to the rack right next to my reservoir and place the air stone right inside my reservoir. This is going to oxygenate my reservoir and provide the plants with some protection against algae growth and disease growth, and also it helps them better soak up the nutrients in the water. All right, so finally, I'm gonna add in my peristaltic pump with one tube into our liquid plant fertilizer and one tube into our reservoir. And what this is gonna do is allow me to completely automate the process of keeping my levels right in the reservoir. Now, the absolute last thing to do is clip on fans to each level so that they can blow air over the entire tray. So that covers the whole building process of this hydroponic system. All we have left to do is automate it, which we'll be going over in the next and final video of this series. This is an essential video to watch because we're gonna be teaching all about the valuable metrics to watch to make sure your system stays happy and healthy. If you have any questions or comments, please be sure to leave them in the comment section down below. We would really love to hear from you. Beyond that, we would also really appreciate it if you would leave a like on this video and subscribe to the channel, but only if you found value in this content. Now, if you're all done with your hydroponic build and you would like to learn how to automate your system using Kai, the Felix Smart Controller, click on part 3 of this video series. I'll see you there.